to recognize the Teacher Leadership Academy that was referenced earlier. I've attended those presentations every year and talked about their projects and shared the different things that those teachers and leaders have presented on and the work they're doing in their schools. So I did want to give them recognition. I also wanted to thank, I was looking around to see who's still here, wanted to thank Leah Mitchell and Vonette Chandler for their efforts in supporting our leaders who are working to get their credentials to become school-based principals, assistant principals, and even district leaders. As a direct result of the partnership that we have with the University of Tampa, we have employees who are in the process of earning their credentials for ed leadership. They're starting to get them registered for classes now, and I'm grateful that our district is supporting these employees in pursuing their goals and filling critical needs in our schools. And lastly, I just want to say happy holidays, Merry Christmas, and thank you to all of you. I appreciate you.
Okay, Ms. Quimby, I'm sorry I didn't see you leave the room.
Yeah, I apologize. I did that. Just also attended the FSBA conference, and just acknowledging also, you said a lot of what I was going to say, Ms. Baudouin, about acknowledging the Teacher Academy. And I would, again, like to thank Mrs. Kuhn and Gary Sawyer for all your work with this transportation situation and solving the problem the best way that we can. We appreciate all of the work. The letter as well, it's so important, the letter that Melissa Musselwhite wrote, that is mm-hmm. tremendous, and I think she's left, but we thank her for that. And wish everybody Merry Christmas and Happy New Year. Okay.
Mrs. Harding.
Yes. like I mentioned earlier, I did got the opportunity to visit or to go to the Florida School Board Association Winter Annual Conference. I learned a lot, but the speaker that was most inspiring was Florida Teacher of the Year, Ms. Sarah Ann Painter. She spoke to us about finding joy, which I thought was a very important message for us all to hear. So I thought it was appropriate to share because we're in this holiday season, which is about joy, like I mentioned earlier. So I wanted to kind of share like what she spelled out joy to be. She made it like an acrostic poem. And she said, J stands for joining with others, building authentic relationships in your classroom and in your workplace. O stands for ownership. Own your practice, own your data, and by doing so, empower your students and families to know their child's data too. Stay reflective by learning and setting goals. And Y is the power of yet. We all have the ability to improve and have a growth mindset. Sarah emitted joy as she spoke, and she spoke so inspiring and so great, and I'm so grateful for the opportunity that I had to hear her speak. And speaking of joy, I got the opportunity to visit two schools this week that were showcasing great things that students are doing. For example, Cruise Lake Middle School, I attended their winter conference. It was a lively evening hearing the tunes from the beginning band, the chorus, and the advanced band. Mr. Rowan is a phenomenal music teacher, and I want to thank him for his dedication to our students and the arts. I want to congratulate his students on a wonderful performance. I also got to attend Starkey Kate's Magnet Showcase. I got to see computer science, art, steel drums, orchestra, theater, and dance. And as always, our students just blew me away. It was truly a wonderful evening. Thank you to the teachers, admin, and families who support their students in doing what they love. I, too, want to give a huge shout-out to Mrs. Kuhn and her team. Mrs. Kuhn has worked tirelessly to try and help families with getting before and after school care due to the time change. And I wanted to read one part of an email that was sent to her as well as me into the record. This is a teacher in our district, and she said that her heart is so full knowing that she works for a district that has people who truly care and are both passionate and empathetic about what is happening in our community. You have worked many weeks, including weekends, to address my family's issue and to come up with unique and creative solutions, and I can never thank you enough for your positivity and perseverance. It has brought tears to my eyes. You went above and beyond, and I'm touched and forever grateful. So I wanted to thank you, Mrs. Kuhn, and your team of magic workers who go above and beyond daily for our families and our students. So I'm really grateful for you, so thank you. And finally, I want to wish everyone a happy holiday and a happy new year.
All right, thank you. All right. The Wise Supply store that the foundation is doing is just amazing. They have the store, and then they have beside it, they have another portable full of supplies that they've been able to obtain through all their partners. So that's going to be a big boon to the teachers. The Starkey K-8 showcase was wonderful. I was really blown away by the orchestra that's just been playing for a couple of months. And I really wanted to thank the Florida Orchestra for being such a great partner with that school. That is really going to just send that program sky's the limit. Also attended the FSBA conference, and it's one of the most meaningful conferences I've been to in a while. I've really appreciated the messages that they were sending. There's a kind of an overall fun message of kindness. This is a time we need to be kind to everyone because it is a very stressful time, and by showing kindness is a way that we can reduce that stress for everyone. They even gave us little reminder messages to put on our wrists so we don't forget that. But the overall theme, and it went along with what the Teacher of the Year talked about, was student outcomes. That's why we exist as a school board, to ensure that our students learn. That is where our focus should be. We have a little placard to say we do what's in the best interest of the student, and that is something that we really need to make sure that we focus on, not only what we do, but also in our school board meetings and in our workshops, that we really own that data for our students' outcomes. We showed a lot today in the recognitions that our individual students are getting, but we need to really make sure that we're tracking that all our students are learning. So that was a real big message that I got, and that, you know, the warning was not to get distracted, to make sure that we are focusing on the reason that we're here as school board members, the reason that the district has these schools, and that is to teach our students so that they will learn, they'll be prepared to move on to whatever they want to do in their future, and they have the love of learning. So that's the message I took for that conference, and it was a very powerful message. Want to thank everyone for all the hard work that they've done this year. We're halfway through, which is amazing. Time flies by, and want to wish everyone a very Merry Christmas, Happy Holidays, enjoy time with your family, something that might be a little easier to do this year than the past couple of years. So that is all for me. Attorney Alfonso.
Thank you, Madam Chair. I had one matter that I wanted to bring to the board's attention. I think we just discussed it in the prior minutes at last meeting, but I wanted a reminder. I sent to board members this evening, an email on the appeal for the Barusso matter. And I thought context for the email would be really helpful. The Barusso appeal hearing is scheduled for, I believe, February 15th. It's set for 1 hour. And what I think the board needs to just put in perspective is it's not traditional in the sense that it's a grievance level for appeal, but it's not going to be about facts at that time. It's really going to be about a preliminary issue, which is whether or not the appeal is timely. Rather than put a lot of this on the record, there are two competent lawyers who are involved in the matter, and I sent you briefs, basically legal arguments with attachments for both administration's position and the employee's position. So the point of this appeal that you'll hear in February is the board will have these things. You have plenty of time to read them. You probably can read them before the holidays and forget them and then read them again, actually. And I say that facetiously, but it's true because it's not set for any disposition for a while. On the 15th, the board will have a chance to hear from the attorneys who wrote them to put them in context, make their arguments. What's anticipated is maybe about 10, 15, 20 minutes max for attorneys to make their pitches and their arguments, and then the board can either ask questions or deliberate. And then if the board decides that it's untimely, that would be the end of that matter. And if the board decides that it's not timely, or that it was timely rather, that then the board would reset another hearing for the substance of the grievance. Sorry for that big, long explanation, but I didn't want you to get that email and wonder why you just got 60 or 70 pages of reading. That's really what it's all about.
Merry Christmas to us.
Merry Christmas. Yeah. And that's actually the segue to my next point, which is I don't have any other substantive thing to say, but I do wish everyone who's still here a happy winter break, happy Christmas, and a happy New Year.
All right, and I do show 4 o'clock for that meeting on the February 15th. So okay.
Just clear, most times we're not supposed to read stuff beforehand. This one you sent, and we are free to read it all.
Absolutely, unequivocally free to read, encouraged to do so, and You can individually contact me with questions about any of it if you wish, but again, you probably have a chance to talk with the attorneys who both authored those papers, and they can answer questions as well.
Homework.
All right. Superintendent, anything to add?
No, ma'am.
All right.
Thank you.
Can I add one more thing?
Yes.
I was remiss to not say thank you to the officers at the door. Thank you always for being there. We really appreciate you. And we hope that your families and you have a Merry Christmas and Happy New Year, too. Thank you.
All right. That brings us to public comment on non-agenda items. I'll try